Welcome back to New Rockstars, I'm Eric Voss, and Marvel Studios Eternals has been bombarding us with new trailer footage, promos, featurettes, and behind-the-scenes reveals of how the Celestials plan to disqualify Earth after Avengers Endgame. I mean, seriously, just give me 2.5 hours of these giant armored space dope snowball packing planets together and I'm good. I'm gonna break down all the new footage for the hidden details that you really need to know headed into this film. This video is sponsored by Storyblocks, more on them later. So Marvel head Kevin Feige and producer Nate Moore describe the film with some interesting words.
Eternals explores the very creation of the Marvel Universe itself.
The film also deals very much with the aftermath of Avengers 4 and the state the world is in.
Yeah, Moore refers to Endgame as Avengers 4. Just a little indicator how, from a developmental perspective, he sees the Avengers franchise as a series with possible 5th and 6th chapters. From a set visit by comicbook.com, Moore teased ways to top the crisis of Endgame by either collapsing the universe or go smaller with a Mission Impossible type plot. It's ironic that he uses those examples because Endgame was really a Mission Impossible type heist in which the Avengers shrunk down small that had the effect of collapsing the universe. But it still clues us into the mindset of the Marvel Brain Trust for their next big crossover events. Universe breakers like Multiverse of Madness and tiny stories like Quantumania. The Eternals leader Ajak recaps Endgame.
The people of this planet brought everyone back with a snap of a finger. The sudden return of the population provided the necessary energy for the emergence to begin.
The emergence refers to the apocalyptic event that the Celestials will use to bring an end to their failed experiment of mankind on Earth. As the creators of the cosmos, the Celestials have returned now, including Ereshkigal the Judge, Jemiah the Analyzer, Nezar the Calculator, and Hargan the Measurer. The Avengers snapped half of all life back, playing God, and creating a universe-wide energy surge that has now triggered the Celestials to topple mankind's Tower of Babel. 7,000 years before this, these gods brought to Earth the 10 Eternals, extraterrestrial immortal beings who, in the film we have learned, come from the planet Olympia, which in the comics was a city on Earth, jumping from Greece to Antarctica to the Negative Zone, then back to Greece, but here it's a whole other planet. The Eternals' task was to eliminate the Deviants, a separate parasitic alien race who go planet to planet, killing that planet's apex predators, who then started hunting mankind. But being tasked with protecting mankind, the Eternals vanquished the Deviants, and then afterward disbanded. Now, thousands of years later, the Deviants have returned. That return could be the apocalyptic emergence that Ajak described, but I have also speculated that the true emergence will be that of a sleeping Celestial inside of our planet, ready to hatch out and blow the place up, like Tiamat, the dreaming Celestial from the comics. And I base this on trailer footage showing an unnatural implosion of the crust, as well as Cersei in some underground location nearing what might be Celestial flesh on a macro scale. Now, Salma Hayek confirmed that her character is the only one who can talk to the Celestials, and that puts her in an awkward spot with her fellow Eternals, saying, "I decide what I tell when I tell them." That implies some massive secret kept from the other Eternals, and I think this world-breaking emergence could be it. Now, one interesting shot shows Ajak absorbing the golden orb, just like in the trailer shot when Ereshkigal dropped that in her. Here, the blue pillars behind her erase away. This could be what it looks like when she communes with the Celestials, mentally transported to whatever their cosmic location is. By the way, I love all their costumes. Costume designer Sammy Shelton Differ said that they based their wardrobe on paintings they made of the universe, nebulas, minerals, planets. And on the clothes, they used paint oil and metal powders so that it wouldn't look like simple fabric. Now, the new footage also gives us new looks at the monstrous Deviants from their exile in this ice cavern, where you can see the remains of another creature, maybe a polar bear that they hunted. Also notice how they exhale warm breath, meaning these Deviants are warm-blooded, they're actually better suited for different climates. And when we see them charging out of their exile with distinct forms of wolf-like predators galloping on all fours and flying dragon-like ones, they move across the terrain, which is how one likely ends up in Camden Lock in London. Now, the Deviants' leader is Crow, who in the comics has a love affair with Thena. There's a new shot of a duel between them, and Crow, it sounds like, will be voiced by Dan Stevens, at least according to an interview with Collider.
What can you say hypothetically about any sort of role role, you may or may not have in Eternals.
Crow comment. I said crow comment, but I don't know if that is cryptic enough.
Now, making the type of high-quality video content that people fall in love with is time-consuming, but Storyblocks saves you time and helps you make your videos that much more lovable. A Storyblocks membership is essential for any creator, and thanks to Storyblocks for sponsoring this video. They have a huge library full of 4K and HD footage, After Effects and Premiere Pro templates, music, images, and sound effects to bring your stories to life. The assets are royalty-free, so you can use your downloaded content anywhere for commercial and personal use. The Unlimited All Access plan gives you unlimited downloads of the over 1 million assets in their library. Choose a plan that works for you from their selection of flexible subscriptions that scale to give you all the contents and tools you need to focus on creating, not worrying about budget. Storyblocks also has this really cool program, the Restock Initiative. They hire creators from marginalized communities to create content more reflective of our diverse world. Starting this month on Indigenous Peoples Day, they're releasing a new round of collections centered around Indigenous communities. So go to storyblocks.com/newrockstars now, or click the link in the description to check out their plans and get one for yourself. New footage also shows the Eternals from a battle at the foot of that erupting volcano. It looks like the Eternals ship has wrecked on this beach after suffering a massive crack in its bulkhead. Here, Phastos assembles impressive weaponry around his fists, Thena slashes through eruption debris, and Cersei turns a boulder into birds, something she seems to be able to do, like turning a London bus into rose petals, but also similar to Doctor Strange turning Thanos' blast into butterflies during their wizard duel. Perhaps the eldritch magic that's practiced by the sorcerers originated with the Eternals and the Celestials. There's this new shot of India. This is actually the Great Wall of India, surrounding the ancient fort of, I'm sorry if I mispronounce this, Gumbalgar. And those raised temples are Hindu temples that are found throughout the subcontinent. This could actually be how Kingo ended up in India, leading to him becoming a Bollywood star in the modern day. Another new shot shows this charred, flattened city, which may be the aftermath of the atomic bomb mushroom cloud that we saw in the trailer footage, perhaps the destruction of Hiroshima or Nagasaki, which leads to Phastos grieving the inhumanity that his technological gifts might have contributed to. There's a new shot of the speedster Makari holding an orb on a beachfront with three oil platforms behind her. That shoreline looks like the same location of that seismic implosion from the trailer. If something is emerging from beneath the earth here, that oil drilling might have contributed to it. Now, one of the more cryptic shots comes from the Change promo, with black smoke wafting off of Thanos' armor, Scott Lang in Endgame, Iron Man in Infinity War, and then Hulk snapping. Why did they add this? Well, this smoke might be part of the general cosmic dust aesthetic that surrounds the Celestials and behind the cast and crew when they talk about this movie. Could just be a way of showing how all these events really unfolded in the eyes of their cosmic judges. We meet Phastos' family.
What's your superpower?
You know that your babysitting privileges are completely revoked.
Dad, I saw him on TV with the cape shooting laser beams.
I don't wear a cape.
Yes, that's right. No capes! But my paranoid brain also reads this as a sign that Icarus might not be totally trustworthy. Like, there was that trailer shot of him raging on Ajax's farm with Ajax in hardly any of the other modern day set shots. I could also see Icarus devolving in a fit of jealousy over Cersei's love for the human Dane Whitman. Meanwhile, I'm also wondering who was the laser dude with the cape that Phastos' son saw on TV. Mysterio from Far From Home, Vision or White Vision from Westview. And then there's another new shot showing Cersei in that vast space with the green triangular panels. This appears to be the reverse shot of the angle in the trailer, with that glowing column now in front of Cersei behind us in the angle of the shot. And notice how Cersei is alone, dressed as she is in another new shot from Druig's rainforest village. This could all be part of a sequence where Cersei finally realizes the dark truth of the Celestials' plans. Now, director Chloe Zhao has confirmed that there will be two post-credit scenes following this film. Now, producer Nate Moore teased that we won't see Dane Whitman as Black Knight with the ebony blade in this movie, but I wonder if he meant within the movie's normal runtime, and that sword could actually be one of the two post-credit scenes. Let me know your thoughts on all this new footage, and you can support New Rockstars by checking out our merch options at newrockstarsmerch.com. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at EAVoss. Follow and subscribe to New Rockstars. Thanks for watching. Bye.